Yo, what's good, man? It's your boy K Camp. Back at it again with another quick video. Well, hopefully it's quick, you know. But as you can see the title, what is required to be of the 15%? What is required to get a woman of high value or quality? Meaning how they move, you know, their cultural riches, things like that, and how they are as a woman from beginning to end. For those of you with wisdom, obviously you know what I'm talking about. But one thing I do want to say before I hop into this video, one thing about being at the 15%, you know, it's not about how much money you have, it's not about your stats, cars, nothing. It's none of that. None of that matters. It's all about how you move as a man, okay? And one tip that I would give to you younger brothers who is new to this walk, new to this journey, again, like I always say, it was never about skin color. It was never about any of that. This is simply about getting away from the negative nonsense. Now, when you're dealing with women of other cultures and other races, it is definitely key to know who you are. Those of you who definitely follow the scriptures, we understand where a lot of these cultures get their ideologies from. So when you're dealing with these other nations of women, again, they know you are the Israelites. They know you are the Jews. They know you are the Moors. But that's just the basics. And most, 85% of the black manosphere community, whatever, they're not going to accept that, which is why they're going to continue to fail. Okay. And I don't care anymore. When you have cultural competence, when you have wisdom, and then on top of that, you add in the swag with the righteousness, right? You are more likely to pull one of those princesses, a very, very, you know, beautiful woman inside and out, because you have all the pieces and tools to make such a marriage or relationship work. Now, it'll definitely help if you have experience being around these type of women. It'll definitely help if you have experience or experienced real love before, as I saw in the videos, the few women on the earth who they'll see a homeless man and take a man as a husband. They'll see a poor man and they will actually, you know, let him know that, like, yes, I want to be your wife. Like, not, they're not being thotty cakes, leftovers, none of that. Oh yeah. And like I always say, you definitely have to have intelligence and wisdom. You cannot get these women. You cannot be the 15% if you don't have wisdom, if you're not sincere, and if you're not afraid to be vulnerable. Like, a lot of these women, they want to see a romantic side. Like, hey, you're not dealing with a scrag. You're not dealing with a damn thotty cake. Now, like I always say too, to be of the 15%, we're not talking about those who go get white women, Arab women, Persian women, Filipino women. We're not talking about those who go outside the country just to get the rocks off. Okay? If you're doing that, you're not part of the 15%. Okay? We're talking about those who actually genuinely do this. Now, one thing about being the 15% is that it's a sense of freedom, a sense of, you know, having a free spirit. Free spirited means you don't have to worry about second guessing. You don't have to have so much animosity and anger towards these beloved princesses. Okay. Now, of course, this is where common sense come in. You always try a woman. It's easy. It's pretty easy. Okay. But back to the elegance, man. One thing I love about, you know, being a 15% naturally is that you have to carry yourself as a prince. So again, if you know that your ancestors were actually royalty, that we spread our seed all throughout the earth, and I'm talking to those, the few who actually understand, to me it's an honor to do such, because now you have the world at your hands and you're going to listen. Let me tell y'all something. If you allow a freaking Karen, if you allow Cardi B, a Megan Stallion, a city girl, a Becky G. If you allow these scrags of Indie Nation to take you away or take you away from your goals and your marriages and stuff like that, dude, I'm trying to tell you, it's not worth it, bro. It's not worth it at all. I don't care how good this woman looked, none of that. It's not worth it, bro. So again, having wisdom, knowing history is key to impressing these women. Okay, these Harvard and Yale type women. I mean, that doesn't mean anything. But we have, listen, as an Israelite male, you have the ability to unlock, dark holes in the brain. Okay, let me explain why. You have men of the other nations literally killing their women, abusing their women if they even show an ankle. But then you have the crayon community who's bound down to worshiping their women, and their women getting them killed. So everything is ass backwards, bro. But it takes a man of wisdom to see that. It takes a man of knowledge and understanding to see that. And genuinely, show this woman, the sauce. Show this woman what it feels like to be a woman. Many foreign princesses don't know what that feels like, which is why you are at the advantage. But the manosphere and these community clowns, even your own family, they're going to try to convince you, oh, you can't get them because they're racist. They're this and this and that. Well, you give them power when you're stupid like that. You don't research shit. And not to mention, most in the manosphere are faithless as shit. See what I'm saying? So it's a lot of things that go into a man, but it's very beautiful. These women are willing to have their babies. Let me tell you something. Pakistani women, Persian and Arab women, the ones who's actually solid, they don't play that. They do not play that, bro. The sexy, I'm talking about the sexy ones. If they actually feeling you and they want your kids and your babies, and look at this. The black woman being a bedwinch. But look, they don't play that, man. See what I'm saying? Especially as a so-called black man in Israel, no. Listen, you are, and again, top 15%, you are rare, okay? So put yourself high on the marriage market. I mean, again, I showed y'all my other page. Again, have a hobby, bro. Live a righteous life. Live a godly life, man. You'll be put above anything. Not only that, when you're culturally competent, when you're part of the 15%, and when you're humble, and you show them that side of like, look, I'm strong, I'm masculine. You know what I'm saying? But it's deeper than that. I gotta stop thinking like animals and think just because that she's a white girl or a so-called Hispanic girl, whatever, or even a black chick. I gotta stop thinking like just because they look a certain way, that they act a certain way. And definitely check this woman's background, bro. See what I mean? So the reason all of this ties into being in the top 15% is because your vibration, your energy, and your spirit is only going to attract those certain type of women. I'm talking from experience. But when you dwell and you manifest in that manosphere, angry logic, and you dwell in that, that simp ass logic, that fresh, they got fresh and fit and all these weird dudes being exposed. You got hundreds and thousands of these Negroes in this YouTube space who literally only talk about getting pussy, but they're not talking about nothing world. They're not talking about building families. They're not talking about rebuilding the community. They think rebuilding the community means pumping and dumping and complaining about each other. Nah, man. Also, SYSBM is not for men who, this is not no, oh, well, I can't get, I'm gonna just make the black woman mad. No. Y'all taking away the vibration, bro. Okay? Simple. So, again, dealing with those rubies, those diamonds in the rough, right? Dog, I mean, you have to genuinely give them something to love for. I mean, yes, you may have wisdom, you may have knowledge, you may even have money, and you may have everything she could want, but at the end of the day, if you really the 15%, you got to know how to tame their hearts, like deeply. You got to know how to use, this might sound messed up, you got to use their emotions against them, man. Okay, righteously though. That's the difference between me or SYSBM. That's the difference between a lot of us, man. Now see what just popped up, bro. Kevin Samuels, the damn agent. all these dudes are lame agents, man. I don't know why they can't understand. Listen, I don't even. It just goes to show you that, you know, they want to be there, bro. I don't, common sense, if you really didn't want to be there, you wouldn't do it. So when you hear these Black Manosphere dudes in real life and on a computer or whatever, when you hear anybody saying like, oh, you know, I want to do this, and they keep complaining about the same thing over and over, bro, just leave that person. But anyway, back on the vibration. Cultural competence, it will take you very far. I mean, for example, if you're dating somebody who's a Muslim, and me personally, I know Muhammad learned from the Israelites. That's actually in history. But see, when you understand secular history, you're able to navigate through many things, and you're able to offer basically the world without having a world, man. And what real man doesn't want a woman, especially a virgin, to himself, two or three wives to yourself, sexy, beautiful, gorgeous, dope. I mean, you have everything at your hands, and they want you to throw that away. Nah, man. Another tip about walking this walk, man. Of course, dude, be yourself, man. Be yourself. Because that way, that person or that woman, that foreign shawty, she knows who you are. Like, she doesn't have to put on this fake persona and vice versa. Like, you still have to actually connect with this woman and her soul. See what I'm saying? And that way you're able to be very romantic. You're able to do all these things that you see in the movies, but righteously, man. So again, they don't complain about adultery. And again, the Philippines has over an 85% virginity rate. So they don't play about adultery. They don't play about none of that, you know, but it's beautiful, man. It's very beautiful. I mean, don't listen to these men who pump and dump and settle for trash, man. Because technically speaking, those households are not actual marriages, man. Well, you know, you see, brother, you can still, you know, settle down and get, you know, with a woman who got less bodies. No, bro. We're not doing that, man. We're not a part of the 85%. We are the 15%. Okay? That's why it's funny how, again, that y'all get in these spaces and start acting up and start acting crazy. No, man. On top of that, if you're already sexually appealing, you have everything to your benefit, dude. So, bro, just the vibrations is everything, and your mindset is everything. And me personally, I'm getting back on being consistent with it. See what I'm saying? Because I feel it getting closer. But, you know, dealing with these scrags, even since I was a baby, I've always liked the mamacitas. I've always liked nurturing women who were solid. Sidney McLaughlin types who were solid, yo. Like, I don't know why these Manosphere dudes, Doran Fine, Shikari, all these other... Listen, man. No, bro. No. So, I even had people tell me, like, man, you attract those girly girls, those very sweet types. And who wouldn't? They're the best ones. You know what I mean? That doesn't mean they can't be strong or intelligent or whatever. And one thing about being a 15%, I mean, you obviously, in my opinion, you need to attract, go get you an intelligent woman. You know what I'm saying? I don't think any man of quality, any man that have common sense, especially a man that's of faith, why would he get, you know, a woman of ignorance and, you know, retardation? That doesn't make any sense. Especially a woman who stands upright. I mean, and check this out. I've seen times where, and then they took these videos down, but you had beautiful Indian chicks who, you know, they were afraid to go tell their parents about their boyfriend. And don't get me wrong, I can't really blame a lot of the nations for their, you know, prejudice towards our people. Because it's like in 2021, it's getting to a point to where it's like, dog, it's so much evil ignorance. Like, bro, what did y'all expect for them to do? I'm not justifying any bullshit at all. I don't condone none of that. But it's the fact that they're desiring you way more than ever, bro. But, like, due to our people's ignorance, being destroyed for lack of knowledge, they're not going to win. But I'm saying that to say, look, okay, once you defeat these weird stereotypes and blah, 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 dog, go put some babies inside this woman. Go build a harem. And, bro, we have to I don't know how long I got on this earth, but if I can do build separate communities and not just with white women or whatever, bro, we need men and women of high quality, man, the 15%, not these fake alphas, not this manosphere. I'm talking about the whole world. Okay, you have Asian chicks who are basically making black men kings over there because they know the history. See what I'm saying? And I don't like being in that vibration of like, yeah, man, let me just go around hating women and hating this certain type of man, because it'll throw your vibration off. It'll basically cover up your wisdom. It'll cover up the true side of you. And I don't want that to happen. That's also too, you know, stay in the, like, look, stay in the gym, stay fit. I mean, if a woman can take a man from being homeless and give him a car, give him a house. I have a brother today. He told me, like, look, you know, he had a woman that wanted to be with him, but, you know, he can go to college. But, you know, her parents offered him a car. They offered him, you know, things. But being a man of integrity, you know, we don't really, this is us personally, you know, we kind of feel like if it's not genuine, especially, you're trying to, you know, shit. I didn't mean to have that on the screen, but, and no, we don't condone same sex either. But look, what I was gonna say? Oh, but yeah, it's kind of like, don't let them buy your love or, you know, treat you as property. Nah, man, it's way deeper. Okay, going into the history of the Spartans, man, go into the history of the Etruscans, man, of everything, anything. Okay, on top of that, cultural competence being the 15%, if you're very spiritual consistently, you know, it'll relieve you from headaches, even if you're single. And I'm saying this for myself, even if you're single, it'll relieve you from headaches about the trash other women. Okay, that's why we tell people in real life and in the world, like, look, harlots are easy to come by. But again, 15%, you know, listen, I love anime. Get into some anime. Do something that's dope. Anime is about Israelites anyway. But don't let nobody bring you on the plantation. I don't care who it is. Like, and think to yourself this. Ask yourself, why do these people, when you get a functional marriage, when you get a beautiful, deep, loving, harmonious relationship that they could have the same exact thing. Why would you allow them to tear that down? I'm tired of losing precious things to me due to somebody else's control. You see, why should you have to settle for women of any race who know better? Like, okay, I so-called love this man, but I'm gonna waste time anyway. And nah, bro, that ain't love. That's wasting time. You die and then what? No, man. So, and one thing, let me tell you something. I had an English AP in high school, right? And this one girl now, this Pakistani girl, she's kind of cute. She's a little cutie. But, you know, of course, me being in a different environment, it was kind of weird, and I didn't fit in. And I was going through a lot, so they definitely never even saw the real side of me. But I'm saying this to say, this woman, dude, she'll literally, and these are, listen, them Indian chicks making straight A's all the time. And you would think, like, being an athlete or being whatever, I wouldn't even look at my best, bro. And she was still breaking her neck to look at me, yo. Like, she'll be sitting right in front of me. And I think I was the only black guy in the class, or maybe it was only two of them, but an authentic black man from the hood in the class. I was the only one. And so she'll be like turning her neck, you know what I'm saying, playing with her hair. And she was like, she was a little cute thing, I'm not gonna lie to you. And I was like, bruh, I had another girl, this Persian chick, right? She was very gorgeous, very gorgeous. But, you know, I still peep game. I treat women equally, bro. I don't just, oh, she's a Persian. Nah, man, I don't do that. The point was, man, she was eyeing me hard, bro. Hard. And you will find a lot of these, you know, princesses in these extremely difficult classes. I don't need, I don't, That's one thing about this walk. Like, if you are at 15%, you're going to be dealing with so-called men of high caliber according to the status of this world. So, but don't ever fold in. Don't ever give in and not be yourself, man. Upgrade your vocabulary. Meaning, I speak Ebonics a lot. I cuss a lot and everything. But Shakespeare also spoke Ebonics, and he was an Israelite as well. See what I'm saying? Like, you have to flip it on him, bro. You have to actually enlighten them and show them, like, look, miss. And even that's why the Beverly Hill types, the Karens, they can't deal with me. The Sarkeesians, they can't deal with me, bro. They cannot deal with me. But I'm saying that for a mental note, you know, don't ever get discouraged, man. But cultural competence, being part of the 15%, hopefully this video doesn't get taken down. But that's what come with it, man. Don't let these people and dudes and these other men, other nations tell you that you're lame, all this other stuff. Oh yeah, too, being clean and neat, man. I mean, you still keep up your hygiene. You still want to be fresh. I mean, simple things, bro. But also, too, being part of the 15%, you should want something that's precious and meaningful. You shouldn't want something that, you shouldn't want something that's, that anybody can have, man. But again, I mean, beautiful. I mean, beautiful foreign shawties. And listen, when I say shawty, it do something to him. But if you got to be that type of man. You got to be that one man that can do that to him. Now you got to be a shawty. Like, and it's crazy because this is common sense. They start choosing you hard. And it's like, man, you know, I don't want to hurt your feelings. You know, I want her, but I want her too as a wife. And I don't know hormone and shit, but as a wife. And they'll actually do that shit, like, forever, bro. Like, I've seen them take this broke man. They'll be with each other for 30, 40 years until death, bro. Because, especially the mama Cephas, who's righteous, bro. They value that romance. They value that family, man. It's nothing above it, bro. But again, being part of the 15% is a beautiful thing, bro. It's, I don't care how many people watch this video or like it, dog. But this is how I'm feeling. And that's how I'm rocking, bro. With that being said, it's your boy K Camp signing out. Dog, get your wisdom up, your knowledge up, and most importantly, fear the Most High, man. And show that light, baby. And be genuine. Manifest that energy. Manifest that energy. That's what I'm finna focus on, because these scribes and this manosphere, man, got me on my element, man. I'm not gonna lie to you. With that being said, it's your boy K Camp signing out, baby.